Okay, so let me share the screen once again. Sorry for this disturbance. Okay, lot of such things. Okay, able to see screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, I'll take back and we'll go back to our main topic, which we are discussing earlier. Okay, just a minute. Yeah. Yes. So see that here we have been just discussed about these two points. Let me check you. Okay, we actually started with this material master. Okay, then vendor account group and this part we discussed. Okay, then last time also we discussed on this. See, the number range interval now is over. Now, how to define the material groups? Vendor groups are over. Now, let us see the material groups. Okay, see, then just a minute. Okay, see that. So, to define the material groups, what we do. We actually see again, understand the purpose. For what purpose we require this material or defining the material group? See, material groups are generally defined at which level? See, remember, they are defined at your client level. And why you define it? See, to differentiate the various materials. See, in company, you are getting thousands of materials. See, just I came across with one of the video, and where in that video, they were talking about. They were talking about what? How many? Do you know how many parts are required to build a car? Any car, to manufacture any car? How many parts are required? Any idea?
There is in
more than 1,000.
More than
3,600.
3,600. Okay. Any other answer, dear student? I have seen that video, and in that video, okay, according to that video, it's not my judgment. Okay, somebody may be right, somebody says 3,600, right, like this, but the number of parts in a car used are more than your 29,000, means almost 30,000 parts are used. How many? 30,000. Now you imagine how that company will maintain that material for each and every part. And see, we know that they are not means manufacturing all the parts. They actually procure it from the external vendors, okay, from other vendors. And that's why they need to define these material groups very well. Okay, see, it is just one example given here. Okay, an electronic manufacturing organization can classify computer as, see, now computer itself one unit, right? But what they say, somebody are saying it as a desktop. Somebody is saying that television as electronics. Somebody is saying that speakers as sound system. Okay, so we need to classify them accordingly, and they are having their own individual groups as well. So take an example here. If I'm saying one material, fruits, okay, in our daily life, fruit, will you tell me what kind of fruits are there? Okay, there are the seasonal fruits. In a particular season we are getting, there are yearly available fruits, there are certain fruits which will be available for a specific season only. Okay, so like this we may divide them. So same material, but may have different types. Now take an example. Why you are going so far? Take an example of your own mobile phone. There are hundreds of types of them. Okay, we can't even know that how many are there. Okay, see that the now how to define it? How to go for defining the material group? So what I need to define this material group? I need the information. Okay, first configuration step. What I will do? I will either make use of which. Somebody is just near to railway station, maybe in Koparga only. Even I am right now listening at my home also, that please mute yourself. Okay, see that here we are going to use one of the transaction code to create the material group in SAP MM is OMSF. What is it? OMSF. Or you follow the complete path in your SPRO IMG. Inside the logistic general, you will find material master, and under that material master, you can get the setting keys for the fields. And in that setting key for the fields, under this particular tab, go for define material groups. Where you have to go? Define material group. So you'll be able to define your material group. Okay. See then how to go for that. Again, you will enter this in your command field. It's a request. Please mute. Participants, yes, Ganesh Sonone. Okay, please, thanks. see that you are going to create now new your material group. Okay, so to define it, what we need to do, which transaction code is required to define the material group? We need OMSF. Like this, you have to always remember. Again, under which particular main folder it is available? It is under SPRO, IMG, Logistic, General, Metal Master, setting key for the fields. Under it, it is available. Always try to practice or exercise this again and again. Ek ratta marle sarka karayche te. So if somebody asks you, where is the Material Master? How to define the new material group? Immediately you should have the answer. Okay, transaction code is OMSF, or you can follow this path. That's why this particular first thing now is really important to you. So once you enter this OMSF, what, how to define the new material group? Okay, sir, click on new entries. So you will click on new entries. Once you are here, you will be able to view your material groups. Okay, which screen? Okay, your material group screen means this new screen will be there for you. So on this new screen, you have to update 2 points. One is your material group, MATL in short, your MATL group, it is given here. Then you have to enter the key that defines as a material group in SAP. So this might be defined there, or you are allowed to enter that material group. But once it is entered, see, you have to remember this material group then available everywhere by the same code. Okay, and what is the size of that material group code? It is a size of up to 9 digits. So how many digits you can give to that material group identity? 9 digits. Then you have to give the description to that material group. What kind of material it is? Is it your electronics? Is it your anything else? Is it your wooden material? Is it your plastic material? Is it your iron material? Everything you have to mention. And under which category? Suppose I'm saying it is related to computer. I may write computer device. Somebody will say, okay, nut bolts. Okay, for my automobile industry, somebody may put something else. Okay, as per the demand. Okay, suppose there is a pharmaceutical company, they may say ki material, okay, chemicals. Okay, getting this point. So this way they will define that material group. And after this, you will save it and you will be able to create that new material. So just entry is made for that new material. Which new material is going to come in the industry? Okay, it is going to come as a electronics. Okay, by which transaction code you have been created? I have been created it with the transaction code OMSF. Okay. What is the material key is given to it? It is specified here, like this material group key is 00103. So what is this material group key? It is a 9-digit key. It is used to identify that particular material. Okay. Like this, you have to go through it. Okay. So I think you got this point, how to define your material group. Okay. See that we have been seeing these many things. See, these are already done. So I have not taken here. Last time I already gone through it. See, then company code for material management. Okay, up till now, what we have done? We have created material group, vendor group, even specific purchasing organization, everything. Now, how to go with this? Your company code for material management. Okay, so why it is required? See, it is mandatory that, okay, maintaining the your company code for material management. It is mandatory thing. You need to do this. And why? See, if you are not maintaining this company code for material management in your SAP, then you will get an error where you are creating your material master record as the company code does not exist or has not been fully maintained. So you might be defined the company code, but you are not maintained that company code for material management, then it will not be available in this window. It will give an error. So you have to recall, array, where I have been defined that company code? Okay, in define company code step. Okay, you have to go back and you have to check there whether that company code you have been allowed for the maintenance status for the material management. If it is, then only it will be available. Again, you have to go there. You have to save those details in your defining the company code. Once it is done, you will come back in this maintaining the company code for material management. So how to do that? Let us see this detail. Dear student, are you finding this resource is really useful for you? Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
See, yes, because just understanding the matter is not important, but for what, how to do, where to go. I find this resource very nice for everyone. Okay, this tutorialcard.com, they have really given in fantastic way, in the easiest way, the contents. Okay, one can easily understand even what kind of errors are coming, what you have to handle, even those things are given really in nice manner. Okay, now see, earlier code was what we used, or we defined that material group. What is the code for material group definition? That one was OMSF. Okay, now what is the code for defining the company code for, or maintaining the company code for material management? It is OMSY. Okay, See, last time and for your help, now, dear student, you may say, sir, how to define all these codes? But see, time to time, you will get the updates here. But here, in this tutorial itself, for your reference, once again, I'm telling you, here, all the transaction codes are given under the SAP T codes. Just go them one by one. See, when you see complete table now, you will get surprised. You will get bored. Don't do that. Go topic wise, just like how I'm showing you. Okay. And you write down by your own way in your checklist now. Make a list of code and you can write down. Up till now, I have been talked about more than 10 to 12 codes, transaction code. But really, you remembered them. Okay, these many codes are already talked with us. Okay, so what you will do? Okay, now you got the transaction code. You will go in your material master. Under the basic setting, you have to go for maintain the company code for material management. Okay, I'm not repeating now SPRO, IMG and later things. Okay, see then OMSY, you will enter on your SAP Easy Access window. Once you hit this green button or your command field, you will be able to get your next screen that is change view as a material management view on company codes. And here, when you will come on this window, okay, you have to choose the position button. Now you may say, sir, where is the position button? See, at the below of that screen, now you will be able to observe that position button. You have to click on that. Once you click that, okay, you have to enter the company code. Now, my dear student, you may remember we started with this company code TK01. That is for one of the company as a software limited company. For them, we have been created this company code. So you have to just select this company code either by clicking on this particular icon where it is given, or just you enter here, you will immediately get that code activated. And then once it is there, okay, once it is there, okay, you just select your company code. And then in the next screen, you have to enter the year and current period, means what exactly the current year. Okay, then your particular period that for whom you want to find out the details, if it is there or not, then you just press enter. See, once you do that, okay, you will be on this material view on company code screen. See here, you will find the field like ABP and DBP. Okay, it is ABP is not Dr. AB Pawar. Okay, please understand. Okay, here ABP is allows to post inventory transaction to the previous period. Okay, your inventory transaction to the previous period. Suppose some material is purchased, but the entry on that day was not happened in the software or in this. Then to do that, you can check on ABP. So previous entries, inventory transactions, you can show in your field. For that, you have to check that field. Okay, DBP means which prevents posting to the previous period after the posting period change. See, sometime it happens in the company. Okay, so to avoid such kind of previous period entries, sometime you have to do this job. See, these are the two fields associated with your this particular when you are maintaining your material management or maintaining your company code to the material management. You have to take care of this part. Okay, it depends what choice you have taken, whether you want to post inventory transaction to the previous period, then you go for ABP. And if you want to avoid that, then you will go for this DBP. Okay, so that changes or that transaction you will do here. Okay, so this is the part related to your this company code for material management. Similarly, create the material master record. Now, how to create the material master record? Okay, for this purpose, see, you need to already we have been discussed about what exactly this material master data or this record. It is simply what? Which refers to all the material master records that contains the detailed information of your every material, including its stock availability, valuation, sales data, financial details, etc. Okay, everything is maintained in this particular material master record. See, and I already said to create the material master, which transaction code is used? MM01. See that here the process is given. You will enter MM01. Once you enter, you will come to your this particular material type. You will choose your particular material type. It may be raw material or any other that will come here. Once it is set earlier in your this particular module, okay, you will enter. Then length of material code that already is specified here, that may be up to the 18 digit you can enter, or that type you can mention. Then related to this, okay, you will be able to view the different data like basic data, purchasing, general plan data, accounting inside this select views. See here, what you need to do, you choose required views for your material master record. What exactly?
Material master?
Yes.
Can you repeat length of material master?
See, here, First, let us see. See, if you enter MM01, okay, there are two types. See, there are two things you are getting on the screen, just like here, material and material type. Okay. So material is what? See, for external type, what you do? You will enter the alphabetic keys that define as a material code. Okay, you may have some material code. And for internal type, okay, you will keep it blank because it may be your internal material only. See that, but the maximum length of material code is how many digits it is given? Here, see how many? 18 digit. Okay, 18 digit will be there. Now it depends. See that not necessary every time to be used as a 18 digits there. It depends. Okay, depends on a company. See, last time also, I think when I have been shown ranges somewhere, okay, some big code they have been used over here. And material type, everyone knows what kind of material it is you are going to define. So once you do that, now what you have to do? You have to click on this select views. Which option? See, once you select these two, if it is internal record, then or internal material, is it necessary to select the material here? No. If it is external material, then only you will specify here material name and then its type. But if it is internal material and it is raw material, it is known, then you will simply go for, after doing this particular two fields information filling, you will click on this select views. Okay. Or you will make a double click. See, these all above options now are, you can execute with the help of double click. See, when you click on that now on that select views, you will be able to see these many views just like here. Okay. So now it is defined whether that data is related to the sales, it is related to the sales and distribution or basic data or purchasing. Accordingly, you have to select its view type. Okay. See, sometime what happened, after you choose the required views for material master, it may be like purchasing right now, click on the default values and click on the organization level. See, just like here, first select view, maybe suppose purchasing, then you will click whatever the default value for organization level that will be selected. And by clicking on data, even default data will be taken as a part of your, this particular configuration. See, you will go for organization levels and then default settings will be selected here. Okay. See, then once it is done now, then what exactly the organization level? See, it shows us the organization level. It is a plant, TKBL. So if you remember, we have been defined the plant earlier. Okay, so that plant detail will be here. Then where is its storage location? Is a TKRM. Also, we discussed on how to define the storage location also. See, if you are not able to recall right now, please go through the contents. I'll show you where exactly you have to see these details. Then here I'm getting the Bangalore plant detail and then raw material. Then I have to just select view. Means I have to just make it clear. And then we have to update the following information like basic data one, then your packaging material data, and all these details are available here as a part of this particular material. Okay. See, to create the material again, here, please understand basic data. There are two types they have been given. First is basic data one and basic data two, which are maintained at the client level. Means at the first level itself, related to this material, that data is available. So here, you are going to enter this text of material, then units, measuring units, whether you are measuring in a kg, milligram, whatever it is that you are going to give it here, base unit of measure, then your material group. Okay. So it may be there are some features which you want to combine or assign to the material group that can be taken here. Then your old material number, this may be optional field, or you may want to connect you with your previous material number with this current material. So you can do that. Then X plant material status, what it is? See, it is to be blocked for purchasing and warehouse transaction in all plants. You have to update it as a BP, that is blocked for purchasing. Okay. See, then once it is done, your packaging, even information, material status to be maintained. See, if the material master is creating for packaging items, then what you do? You are assigning the packaging item that belongs to that packaging group. So how you do it? See, general data, what is your type, material code, your general data. Okay, basic unit of measure, material group is taken here. Then it is packaging material data. Then it is going to package like this. See, your multi-group package material or reference material for packaging, those details you will mention. Then your purchasing, for that, you are also going to update these purchasing details. And finally, you are getting created your material in this way. See, like again, material code or type, its description, plant from where it is taken. Okay, general data in which again unit of measures, purchasing group is mentioned, order unit is mentioned, material group is mentioned. Then you are going to maintain even purchasing values for that. Then your other data or manufacturing information you will maintain. Similarly, for that newly created material, you need to define where that material is going to be stored. For that, you are going to follow this plant data or storage one. dear student, one thing please remember, for material actually we are following the complete organization MM structure. Okay, you are going to create this particular material and how it is going to be stored in a plant, that details are also mentioned here. See that shelf life data that will be maintained here, maximum storage period for how many days you want to store or months you want to store, that time unit you can specify. Then your okay, then accounting details are also maintained for that particular material, from where it is taken, okay, what is the current valuation of that particular material, and this way your finally the material is created. Dear student, how it is created, see, this is very important topic, please go through it once again. That is what, create material master record in SAP. Okay, see, now you may say, sir, how, why we want to do everything for this material master? Once again, I would like to take you back on our SAP MM enterprise structure. Remember it. What is this SAP MM, your enterprise structure? Okay, let us take on a home. Okay, sorry, I'm here. Okay, so here. See, my dear student, once again, I brought you on the first page. When any material is coming in your organization, actually it goes through this organizational structure of SAP MM. What we did, we found the client, the company code, plant, who purchased that, how it is stored, and how it is even maintained by the purchasing group. By this structure, only your material master record is created. So if you observe carefully, for right now, whatever the material we created, okay, for that we were here, see, we were under this material master. Okay, we created this material master record. Means what we created, we actually maintain all the information related to that material. First, we maintain that we created that material. Okay, then we maintain this type, what kind of type it is under the purchasing. Then we also maintain this basic data, which we require at the client level, basic data 1 and 2. Then packaging details are also mentioned. Then with respect to that, we also mention the details related to your that purchasing. Okay, means what is the financial records and purchasing records are there also created. Then again, in the storage, how it will be kept in that particular data. Okay, and finally, how the account is also associated with that data. Okay, what is the valuation or what exactly the price of that particular material? Everything is maintained as a part of main material master record. So once again, I would like to remind you, the definition of this particular material master is here. See that material master data refers to all the material master record that contains the detailed information of materials such as unit measures, stock availability, valuation, sales data, plant data, MRP, etc. So what we can say that, yes, your material master data mainly consisting of the description of materials that an organization can use for purchasing, keep in stock, and for additional details. Okay, so this part we have been just discussed today. So today I've been covered the topics like this. Okay, first we have been seen what is your vendor group, how to define your vendor group. Actually, that topic we have been taken from this vendor material master data, that is your SAP MM vendor account group. Then how to assign the number range for the vendor account. Then we have been seen what is an, even the same thing is here for number range interval for material type. Then how to define your material group. Then how to go for this particular company code for material management. And then what to, how to create your material master record. Okay, so these topics we have been completed today. Okay, tomorrow we'll go for the next one. See, like this, you please see the, I like this particular tutorial because you have been given in a specific portion, specific compartment, the details. Okay, when I'm saying SAP MM enterprise structure, then what exactly I should know as a part of material management. So those topics, they have been given one by one. Okay, so I hope you understood this. Yes, please. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so tomorrow we'll meet. Will you tell me tomorrow's timing? Will it be fine in the evening or shall I take it in the morning somewhere? Yes, dear student. Tomorrow we are having holiday.
Yes, sir.
Will it be same time? Will it be fine? Same timing, 7 o'clock?
Yes, sir.
Or shall yes, I sir. See, my request to all of you, sometime I found 7 o'clock is sometime not feasible for few students as per the request. Will I start at 7:30?
Yes, sir. No problem.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So tomorrow we will be there at 7:30. please, it's a request to all the students, because we are counting these many hours in your record. Please inform to your other friends also to join. And I know that those who are serious, definitely they are now, they will get everything and they will definitely start to move ahead. Okay. So,
sir,
please.
I have one question, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, in a petrochemical industry, how MM is applicable there?
See, do you know the ONGC?
Yes, sir.
ONGC is the means first, we can say they are using SAP, right? Complete SAP on their. So they also do the same thing. Now, see, what is the raw material for any petrochemical industry? Tell me.
Crude oil.
Yeah, crude oil. So it's each and everything is maintained by them through this SAP. They are creating the material. Means they are creating, first of all, what? For that, as a raw material, that creating the crude oil material. Okay. See then, next thing, once it is created from crude oil, what are the different other materials are get produced internally? Tell me.
Petrol, diesel, plastic.
These are the products. Petrol, diesel, again, what you said?
Plastic.
Plastic.
Yes.
Okay. Then, have you heard about jet fuel also?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, apart from jet fuel, even oil. Okay. Means various oils also we may found, right? So these are the various even material types they are producing, and these are their products finally. But again, there are the vendors for them, various vendors for them. Okay. So I may say ONGC, when they are actually getting the crude oil from their own refineries, means do you think, are they only refining that, or they might be importing it or exporting to others also to do that, right?
Yes.
So right now we are not expert of that, but if tomorrow you will be there, if you know at least this idea what happening, see, that's why I've been said, for manufacturing a single car, if you imagine there are 30,000 plus material requirement or parts requirement, then how much data is to be maintained? Is it possible for any small system to maintain?
No, sir.
Please realize, see, it's a request. He has been asked very nice question. I want to appreciate him, because see, like this, now you have to apply your mind. And my attempt is not only to give the theoretical details. See, I'm not an expert from MM, let me tell you.
Yes.
But I'm trying to give you that hints or that kind of environment you should think from your end. See, I've been given the example from our house, because see, that way my mind, I'm applying everywhere. I'm trying to understand this MM in this way. Okay. So tomorrow when you will go in industry, and if somebody asks you, okay, I'm giving you one scenario, just like here, he has been given. Okay. If you want to apply this material management to the petroleum company or this petrochemical kind of industry, how you will do that? See, in Maharashtra, there is Gharda. Have you heard Gharda Chemicals? JHRDA. Okay. You search it. Their plant is in Mumbai. A lot of even employees are working on SAP there. Even ONGC is using. My one of the close relative, I know that she is working in there. And he said, ki, we are handling everything through SAP only. Okay. Are they really working on a refinery? Are they there in the sea? No. They're sitting where? In the offices. Right. And from that office, they're managing it. See, this is really nice. Means company wants to get benefit of each and every component. Okay. And this way, if the material is maintained, do you think there would be a chances of some errors over there? Yeah, there would be a lot of, means 99% they will get the correctness everywhere. So it is very important.
Thank you.
Yeah. So please apply this way the mind. It is really good exercise, will help you. Just like you are discussing with me, it's a request to all of you, discuss with your own friends who are right now in this group. Ask them a question. You are in a group. Put that question in a group. Okay. Post it and let us see who is going to give the answer. Okay. And if possible, in 1 or 2 days, definitely with IBM student, you will have the session. Okay, but tomorrow I am going to conduct. So session will be with IBM place student for you. Okay, one session with that girl, which I have been told you. So maybe on Friday or Thursday, based on her availability, I'm going to organize her session for all of you. Okay, so you can have n number of questions with her there. Okay. See, I'm actually expecting you should ask the question to those fellows. Okay. And let them answer one by one. Will it be fine?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm planning that one also. Just, okay. It's a request. You are putting some messages to me for access. Okay. See, I have been actually asked to each department coordinator if the student want SAP logon access. Is a different story. Huh? Once again, and SAP education council, which we are providing through the college, is a different part. So for SAP logon, actually, we talked with the primers and they're going to give their server for your practice. So whatever I have been completed so far now, suppose tomorrow you will get that because there is a process, we are carrying out the process. So once you'll get an access now from the primers side on your email, so you have to just practice this part. Okay, so you will be able to do the practice. So we are sending them the details, don't worry. Okay, fine then. Yeah, yes. And one more important point. See, there is one more way is available. Okay, online also we are getting some this kind of practice servers. Okay, right? Practice server. And it's a kind, means I would like to give a hint. Suppose you are not getting SAP logon, then you may get that SAP logon on a rental basis for the practice. Then what you can do, suppose you are 10 students or 4 students or 4 friends, you can take on the name of one of the student and then others can use, others can practice on the same login. That way also student do. But I'm going to give the primers companies one, okay? So don't worry about it. But I'm giving you the ways. There are the ways available. If you find them, you will get the solution. Okay, don't try to spend more money now. You already spent. Yes. Okay, I think that's enough for today. Yes, I'll stop sharing. Stop it.